but I do tend to go on. You must be bored to tears with your old Grandma Falcon.
No?
Well, dearie, did I ever tell you about the first time I killed a man? It was way back in 1942, I believe. All the men were off at war, and just like Rosie the Riveter, I went to work. Except instead of rivets, I handled nuts. I screwed nuts all day long on the assembly line. I was proud to be part of the war effort, but I always felt that there was something more. Mr. Nolting, I'm all done screwing those nuts.
Oh, that's capital, Falcon. Simply capital. Why, you're better at screwing those nuts than any man I've ever had. But now I've got something really important for you, kid. The most important job there is.
You want me to parachute into Berlin and give Hitler what for?
You a woman? You are a panic, Falcon. No, I want you to clean the storeroom.
Oh!
Women.
When I got to the storeroom, there was a man inside with a bomb, a saboteur. Without thinking, I hit him with my mouth. Then I grabbed a hammer and hit him. Then some shields. And then with a bowling trophy. And then with a picture of FDR. And then with an Oxford English Dictionary. And then with one of those things that you shake and it snows inside. And, well, I'm probably forgetting a lot of things, but the point is I beat that man to death.
Falcon! What the? Why, you've caught a saboteur. Is he dead?
Yes, sir. He's dead, all right.
And you killed him, a woman?
Yes, sir.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
But you just killed a man with your bare hands and with some office furniture. You must be traumatized.
Nope, I'm completely okay with it.
Wow, Falcon, come with me. I'm gonna call J. Edgar Hoover. I think we found our girl.
All right!
J. Edgar Hoover himself trained me in the ways of the assassin. And that training, along with my perky good looks and moral relativism, led me to a very successful career in espionage. Oh, and it's also how I met your grandfather and killed him. But that's probably a story for another day. Now, who wants more cocoa?